Einstein said that you don't really understand something unless you're able to explain to your grandmother. Now, you may wonder, what's the difference between the sore-powered Queen Elizabeth and this acanthus leaf which reminds the Corinthian capital? Follow me and I'll show you. To answer what you just said, here are some of my fellow classmates. Valerio and Ricardo. They're twins, but in this video, we're not trying to send one of them in space in order to prove Einstein's special theory of relativity. Instead, we are comparing two well-known phenomena, photosynthesis and the photovoltaic effect. That's why we previously compared Queen Elizabeth with a common Roman leaf. I'm sorry, Your Highness.
These two processes look so different, but are so similar. In fact, in both, there is the word photo, which means light, so they need the sun in order to work properly. Human being is still alive thanks to these fantastical green heroes. They give us the life's key elements that we all know as sugar and oxygen, that allows us to eat and breathe, and through photosynthesis, these elements can be transformed, starting just with a few carbon dioxide, some water, and then we just need the sunlight, a little bit of patience, and that's it. Einstein is largely recognized today for his special theory of relativity, but he did not win the Nobel Prize for this theory, however. He won the award for a lesser-known discovery called the photoelectric effect, which then helped developing the nowadays solar panels. Now, the first postulate says photoelectrons are only emitted from the metal surface if the frequency is measured than the threshold frequency, and hence energy of photon is measured than a work function. The second postulate says increasing intensity increases number of photons and not the kinetic energy.
So, let's take the red color from the light spectrum. This color is going to have a long wavelength. A long wavelength means low frequency. Low frequency is going to be a very weak punch, and the electron is going to be still stuck inside the metal surface. But if we take the green color from the light spectrum, this is going to have a higher frequency because the wavelength is shorter than the red color. Your punch is going to be stronger, and this is going to knock off your electron, like this. The blue color is going to be even more intense, like this. After we explain the photoelectric effect, we can now dive, sorry about the sound, inside the photovoltaic cell.
A solar panel is made of silicon that is sandwiched between conductive layers. Each silicon atom is connected to its neighbors by four strong bonds which keep the electron in place so no current can flow. But solar cells use two different layers of silicon, an N-type silicon that has extra electrons and a P-type silicon that has extra spaces for electrons, called holes. Where two types of silicon meet, electrons can wander across the p-n junction, leaving a positive charge on the p side and creating a negative charge on the other one. When a photon strikes the silicon cell with enough energy, it can knock off an electron from its bond, leaving a hole. The negatively charged electron and the location on the positively charged hole are now free to move, but they only go one way. The electron is drawn to the N side, while the hole will go to the other side. From there, electrons flow through an external circuit, doing electrical work like powering a light bulb, before returning to the positive side of the cell. Think of electrons like tiny little cars blocked in a traffic jam. If a photon knocks off an electron from the silicon layer, then imagine a car that has a free road to its left. After the car left the traffic jam, we will find a hole instead of the car, causing the cars behind to move forward trying to fill that hole. And if our car moves, as a consequence, the cars behind will move too, creating a traffic progress. This traffic progress inside a solar cell is known as electrons flow, which basically means electrical energy. This is the two-faced Janus arch. Those are Corinthian capitals. But this is not the Colosseum.